The noble Ultramarines are the protectors of mankind, crusading through the galaxy, bringing death and destruction to the enemies of the Emperor. In this video, we're going to show you exactly how to paint your Space Marines from the Indomitus box up to battle-ready standard in the colours of the brave Ultramarines. We'll use tips and tricks to get your models on the table in no time at all. So grab your paints and your brushes, and let's get started. Now, to prepare our model here for painting, we've already undercoated it with McCrag Blue Spray. Using a coloured spray in this way really helps speed up the painting process and means you get loads more Space Marines painted. In fact, the only miniatures from the box set we haven't undercoated with McCrag Blue are the Judicia and the Primaris Chaplain, which we've undercoated with Chaos Black, but more on that later on. Now, if you haven't got a can of McCrag Blue in your collection, you can always use McCrag Blue paint out of a pot if you'd like to. Once that undercoat is dry and ready to rock and roll, let's get the base coats down. And the first base coat we're going to apply is Corvus Black, which we're going to paint onto the joints in between our Space Marine's armour. Now for this we're using our medium layer brush, so let's get painting. First of all, let's grab a little bit of paint from the pot here and add it to our palette like this. Now when using a base coat, we're going to add a little bit of water here just to thin it down, not too much, to help the paint go on a little easier. Then onto the Space Marine, here we go, we're going to apply it very carefully now onto the joints in between our Space Marine's armour, so the little rib bits here. Now when applying base coats like this, it's important to try and be as neat as you possibly can. Try not to hit any other parts of the miniature, but don't worry if you do, you can always go back later on and tidy those up. You might find as well when applying base coats that it's not a great coverage on the first coat, so why not go back and give it a second thin coat to get a nice solid colour. There we go, with the Corvus Black painted in between the armour panels there, that's our first base coat complete. Alright, let's move on to the next bit, and that's going to be the metal on the miniature. For this, we're going to be painting the gun, chainsaw blades and exhaust ports on the backpack with lead belcher. Again, we're using our medium layer brush for this. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and onto our palette lock. So again, a touch of water here just to thin it down a little bit, but not too much. There we go, that's perfect. Then onto our Space Marine, we're going to be painting this onto all the bits we want to be metal on the miniature. So for example, we're going to paint the exhaust ports on the backpack here and also those vents underneath here as well. We're also going to paint the teeth of the chainsaw here as well. The engine part of the chainsaw as well, just this bit up here. And also various parts of the gun that we want to be metal as well. Okay, that's the metal done on our Space Marine and the first two base coats of the miniature done. So let's have a look at painting a shade onto the miniature next. And for this, we'll be using a contrast paint, Basilicanum Grey, as it goes over both Corvus Black and Lead Belcher really well. Now for this we're going to be using our medium shade brush. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot here like so and add it to our palette. Now for a contrast paint we're not going to thin this down, but we are going to make sure we've not got too much paint on the brush. There we go, that's perfect. Then onto our Space Marine we're going to very carefully apply contrast paint all over the metal areas and the Corvus Black areas as well. Now at this point you want to be as neat as you possibly can. Try as hard as you can not to go onto the blue areas of the miniature. If you do, don't worry, you can always go back with your McCrag Blue paint in a pot and correct it. All over the metal areas, make sure the paint is not pooling or gathering together, so just use that brush to move it around to make sure you get a nice, even coat of Basilicanum Grey all over. There we go, the Basilicanum Grey has dried on the lead belcher and on the black areas of the miniature, and it's looking really good. But while Basilicanum Grey is open, we're going to use it for something else, because it's really, really good for shading the recesses of ultramarine armour. For this, we're going to be using our small layer brush, and here's how we're going to do it. So grab yourself a bit of Basilicanum Grey from the pot like this, and now onto our palette, we're just going to touch it off like so, just making sure there's not too much paint on the brush. Also, press lightly here, we want to keep a nice thin point on your small layer brush. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature. Here we're going to be applying it very carefully into the recesses between the Ultramarine's armour. So you can see the sort of like shaded area here. We're just going to drag the paintbrush up like so. It's a very thin line like this. And we're going to do this all around the blue armour, anywhere where there's a recess between where plates meet. This is going to take you a little bit of time to do, but trust me, it's going to look fantastic when it's done. And it is going to be worth the effort. So very carefully around the miniature like so, just very carefully painting those lines in like this, anywhere where there's a recess between blue armour plates. Don't worry too much if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on with the McCrag Blue in a pot and tidy it up if you want to. So there we go, we've been around the entire model with that Basilicanum Grey and dropped it into the recesses of the blue armour. Now it's taken a little while to do that, but it's really worth spending the time to make it as neat as possible to get that really cool clean look for your Space Marines. All right, so let's have a look at painting some more of the miniature. I'm going to start off by painting our Assault Intercessor Sergeant's tilting plate with white. This effect can also be used on the helmet of your Blade Guard veterans and the shield of your captain too. We'll start off with a base coat of Korax white, and over the top of that we'll add a contrast paint, Apothecary white. First of all, that base coat of Korax white. For this we're using our medium layer brush. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, like so, and onto our palette as always. We're not going to thin this down too much, just a little bit maybe to help it go onto the model a little easier, like so. Perfect, maybe a bit more paint. There we go. Then onto the miniature. We're going to be painting this onto the tilting plate of our sergeant like so, all over, like this. Now you might notice this goes on quite thinly, so allow this to dry, and then once it has, apply a second coat over the top of it to get a nice strong base coat. Next up, let's paint a very thin layer of Apothecary White over the top of that tilting plate. Here we're just going to apply it over the top here with a medium layer brush, and just make sure we're moving that paint around so it doesn't pull anywhere. See at the bottom here it's pulled around? Just going to move that paint around there, make sure it's a nice even coat all over. And there we go, that's the white armour done. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting red armour. Now our Marine here is an Assault Intercessor Sergeant, which means his helmet's going to be red. And we're also going to paint the right hand side of the tilting plate red as well. We'll start off with a base coat of Mephiston Red, and after that's dry we'll then go back to using a contrast paint, Flesh Terrors Red, to line in those recesses much like we did with the blue armour earlier on. First of all, time for that base coat of Mephiston Red. Let's grab our medium layer brush again and get straight to it. Let's grab a bit of paint from the pot here and add it to our palette, like so. Just a little bit like this. Again, we're going to thin it down just a little bit, not too much though, just like that. That's perfect. Then, onto our Marine, we're going to very carefully paint the Mephiston Red onto the helmet of our sergeant like so. Now you'll notice this probably goes on a little thin, so you probably want to have a couple of layers of this going on as it goes on, just to get a nice solid colour. We're also going to be painting it onto the right hand side of our tilting plate. Now if you're feeling brave and you fancy it, I'm just going to draw a nice line up like so from the bottom of the tilting plate to the top, like this, up to the top. Nice straight line like that, and then we're going to paint in the right hand side of the tilting plate with Mephiston Red as well. Next up, we've grabbed our small layer brush and we're going to apply Flesh Terrors Red contrast paint again into the recesses of the armour planes on the helmet and the tilting plate too. This method of painting red arms is also useful if you want to paint the chaplain's bolt pistol with the red casing too. There we go, that's the red sections done. Right, let's apply some bling to our ultramarine. Let's paint that gold all over. So for this, we're going to be starting with a base coat of Retributor Armour, and then we're going to be moving on to a layer of Reichland Fleshade Gloss over the top of it. That'll give some nice contrast on the gold, but also because it's gloss, keep our gold nice and blingy and shiny. Now let's first of all start off with that base coat of Retributor Armour, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, and onto our palette like so. Just a touch of water here, not too much, just a little bit, maybe a bit more paint there, and that's perfect. Then, onto our miniature. Let's pick out all the areas of gold we're going to be painting. So let's look at the shoulder pad trim here, for example. We're painting that there. But be nice and neat here as possible. Try not to hit any areas of blue. If you do hit the blue, just go back with your McCrag blue paint in a pot and paint it over. We'll paint the shoulder pad trim here. Look out for other areas of gold around the miniature as well, such as a small sigil on the arm here. And also the hilt of the chainsword here. And don't forget, of course, to paint that famous Aquila on our Ultramarine's chest. Next up on the gold, add a wash of Reichland Fleshade Gloss over the top like this. You want a nice thin coat, just enough to make sure it's got a nice bit of contrast in the recesses. Don't overload the brush too much. Just very carefully work it around all of the gold areas like so. By Terra's throne, that's some shiny gold. Alright, up next let's paint the leather on our Space Marine. This is going to be the pouches around his waist and his belt as well. For this we're going to start off with a base coat of Monfang Brown, and over the top of that we'll add a wash of Agrax Earthshade to shade it down. Again, for this we're using our medium layer brush. So let's grab a little bit of this Monfang Brown here, put it onto our palette here. Just a touch of water here, just a cheeky little amount, just to thin it down, just a little bit. There we go, that's perfect. Then, onto the miniature. Here we're going to be painting this onto the pouches. So you see at the back of the Space Marine here, we've got this big gun holster here. We'll paint that Mornfang Brown as well. And we'll paint the belt around his waist as well with Mornfang Brown too. Try and be as neat as you possibly can here. Try not to get anything onto the blue or the other parts of the model you've already painted, but don't worry if you do. You can always go back and correct it if you need to. Next up, grab yourself a medium shade brush and add a cheeky wash of Agrax Earthshade over that Mornfang Brown. A nice even coat all over to make sure it doesn't pull in any of the recesses. You can see here it's gathering together. I'm just going to move it around with our brush and just make sure it doesn't pull. And there we go, that's the leather done. There's just a couple of colours left to do on our Assault Interceptor Sergeant. First of all, we're going to take a Baden Black and paint it over the casings of both the bolt gun and the chainsaw as well. Then we'll take Nocturne Green to pick out his eyes and the little control panel on his arm. First of all, a Baden Black. And for this, again, we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here onto our palette like so. Just a little bit of water to thin it down. Just makes it going on a little bit easier. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature, we're going to be placing the Abaddon Black onto the casing here of the chainsaw on the assault intercessors and also onto the bolt pistol here as well. So the casing all over the bolt pistol here too, just like that. The last colour we're applying is Nocturne Green, and we're using a small airbrush here to add it to the control panel on our sergeant's arm like so, and also onto his eyes at the front as well. Now, a quick tip here, I'm painting the eyes on this particular model green because it's a sergeant. But if you're painting a normal blue-headed space marine, paint the eyes red, say corn red. And there we go, that's our Assault Intercessor Sergeant complete. All right, go back and use those same techniques on the rest of the miniatures in your Ultramarines army there, and you'll have most of them painted, but there's a few other details we've not yet covered. Let's look at next the Outrider Sergeant and the light flesh on his head and the dark metal on his bike's exhaust ports. First of all, that light flesh on his head. And for this, we're going to start with a base coat of Wraithbone. Over the top of that, we'll apply a contrast paint, Gilliman Flesh, to give a really cool flesh look. Let's first of all start with that base coat of Wraithbone. And for this, we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot here and onto our palette like so. Now, for a contrast paint, we want quite a thin base coat here. So we're going to apply a little bit of water here just to thin down that Wraithbone. Perfect. Then, onto our Outrider Sergeant. Here, very carefully, we're going to be painting it onto the flesh of his head like so. Try as hard as you can not to hit other areas of the miniature. And also you want this a nice thin base coat here, so you might have a couple of thin layers rather than one thick one. But don't worry, that's absolutely fine. So nice thin base coat here, apply it nice and neatly. Once that Wraithbone's dried, we're going to apply a layer of Gilliman Flesh contrast paint over the top. Here we're using a medium shade brush and we're applying it quite thickly, but make sure as it dries it's not pooling in the recesses, so just move the paint around like this as it starts to dry. And there we go, that's the face done. Next up, let's have a look at painting the dark metal on the exhaust ports of his bike. This is also the same way we're going to paint the melter gun barrels on the eradicators too. First of all, we'll start off with a base coat of Balthazar Gold. Over the top of that, we'll apply a layer of Agrax Earthshade to shade it down and make it look filthy and beaten and old. First of all, that base coat of Balthazar Gold, and for this we're using our small base brush. Again, let's grab a bit of paint from the pot here and apply it to our palette. Now we're going to add just a touch of water here, not too much for metallic paint, but just a little bit. There we go, that'll do nicely. Then, onto our Outrider Sergeant. Here, we're going to place it very carefully all over the exhaust ports on the back of the bike here. So you can just see these parts of the bike here. Try as hard as you can here not to hit any of the other parts of the model. Again, neatness is the key. You might find as well you need a second coat to get a nice solid base coat colour here. That's absolutely fine. Once that Balthazar Gold has dried, it's time for a layer of Agrax Earthshade over the top. Here we're using a medium shade brush, just applying it quite liberally over the top of our Balthazar Gold, just to make it look all dirty and beaten and old. And there we go, that's the dark metal on the exhaust ports complete. Up next, let's have a look at the Eradicators, and here we're going to be painting the Sergeant's head with dark flesh. So for this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Wraithbone, and over the top of that, we'll apply contrast paint again, this time Saigor Brown. First of all, that base coat of Wraithbone, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot like so, and again onto our palette here, just a touch of water to thin it down, not too much, but a little bit like that, maybe a bit more. There we go, perfect. Then onto the miniature, we're going to be applying Wraithbone very carefully all over the model's head like so. Again, you want a nice thin coat here, as contrast paint works better over thin coats, so you might find you need a couple of thin coats to get a nice solid coverage of the Wraithbone. Once that Wraithbone base coat is dry, apply a layer of Saigor Brown contrast paint over the top. Here we're applying it quite thickly, but make sure you're moving the paint around again as it's a contrast paint. You don't want it to pull too much on the larger flat areas. It's just being very careful here not to hit any of the other areas around the miniature. And there we go, with the Saigor Brown dry, that's the dark flesh complete. All right, it's time to move on to a few more parts of the miniature now, and it's time to go over to our Bladesguard Ancient. We're going to start off by painting the tabard and the parchment of the Purity Seals, which we're going to paint in the same way. We'll start off with a base coat of Rakarth flesh, and over the top of that we'll add a layer of skeleton horde contrast paint, which we're going to slightly thin down with contrast medium. But more on that later. First of all, it's time for that base coat of Rakarth flesh, and for this we're using our medium layer brush again. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, add it to our palette like so. Again, a touch of water just to make sure it's going on nice and thin like that. Perfect. Then onto our Bladeguard Ancient. We're very carefully going to paint it onto the tabards and the Purity Seal parchment on the miniature like so. So be very careful here to just paint the tabards and the parchment and the Purity Seals. Don't hit any of the other parts of the model if you possibly can avoid it, but don't worry if you do, you can always go back later on and tidy those mistakes up. There we go, that's the Rakarth flesh applied. All right, let's have a look at that Skeleton Horde contrast paint next. Now here we're going to be thinning it down with just a touch of contrast medium. And the reason we're doing that is we want the colour to be slightly thinned down so that nice creamy colour of the Rakarth flesh comes through on both the parchment and the tabard. And here's how we're going to do it. Grab yourself your medium shade brush. Then with your contrast medium, add about 5 brushfuls of contrast medium to your palette like so for 5. Then clean your brush off, nice bit of tissue paper. Then a very tentative brushful of Skeleton Horde gets added into the mix like so. You can see it's a nice thin down version of Skeleton Horde, and that means the pigment won't be quite as strong. Load your brush up as normal, and then onto our miniature, we're going to very carefully apply it onto the tabards and the parchment of the miniature. Just make sure you're doing nice long strokes, bringing the paint down like so. And also, oh, I just made a mistake there, wipe away with my finger. Also, try and make sure you're not going over any of the parts of the model like I just have there. We can always go back later on and touch that up. And also make sure you're not allowing the paint to pool in the recesses. So just make sure you're moving the paint around as much as you possibly can. There we go, that's the Skeleton Horde dried on the tabards and the parchment. All right, up next, let's have a look at painting the wax of the Purity Seals. For this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Barracknar Burgundy. And over the top of that, we'll apply a contrast paint again, this time for Lupus Pink. For both of these, we're going to be using our medium layer brush. Let's grab a little bit of paint from the pot here, this is Barracknar Burgundy, and onto our palette like so. Just a touch of water again, as always, with the base paint. Perfect. Then, onto the miniature, we're going to be applying it very carefully onto the wax seals. These are the round bits at the top of the Purity Seals, like so. Just making sure we're just being very careful here not to hit any of the other parts of the miniature. There we go. Nice and neat. And next up on the seals, we're adding a cheeky touch of Volupus Pink contrast paint. Just very carefully touch over the top here just to give a sort of more pinky effect on top of the burgundy. And there we go, that's the Purity Seals done. All right, let's tackle that giant skeleton hanging from our Ancients banner. And for this, we'll start off with a base coat of Morghast Bone. We'll then apply a wash of slightly thinned down Agrax Earthshade over the top of it before picking out the straps holding the skeleton onto the banner with Wildwood contrast paint. Let's first of all start off with that Morghast Bone base coat. And for this, we're going to be using our small base brush. Let's take a bit of the Morghast Bone from the pot here. Again, we're going to be thinning it down just a touch on the palette with a little bit of water, like so. Perfect. Then onto the miniature, we're just going to very carefully paint it onto the skeleton here. And also don't forget to paint the bony hand that he's holding in his hand down here as well. It's important to be as neat as possible here. Try as hard as you can not to go onto the gold areas. Don't worry if you do, you can always go back and correct it later. Next up, we're adding a layer of Agrax Earthshade over the top. This will shade down the bone nicely. We've actually added a little bit of water to the Agrax Earthshade here to thin it down just a touch, but not too much. We're going to be applying it all over the bone on both the skeleton here and the hand down by the side as well. Next up on the skeleton, we've taken a small layer brush and some Wildwood contrast paint. We're just going to very carefully pick out these straps holding the skeleton down to the banner. Be very careful here. Try not to hit the bone, but don't worry if you do. It's brown and it won't matter too much. It won't show up too much. So there we go, that's the skeleton on the banner done. You can also see we've been back in and painted the metal areas, so the manacle and the big nail holding him on there, with the metal technique we saw earlier in this video. All right, let's have a look at the lieutenant next. And first of all, let's have a look at the Volkite glow on his pistol. For this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Wraithbone. Over the top of that, we'll apply a contrast paint, Blood Angels Red, to get that glowy effect. First of all, that base coat of Wraithbone. For this, we're using our medium layer brush. Again, grab a little bit of paint from the pot here, onto the palette. Little bit of water, not too much. There we go, about perfect. Then onto the miniature. It's going to very carefully apply it to the Volkite pistol here, just the glowy bit, the coils on the end of his pistol here like so. Very careful, try not to hit the black we've already painted earlier on. Don't worry if you do, they can always go back and tidy up the Abaddon Black pot if you want to. And just very carefully paint those coils in there, like so. Then, over the top of this, we're applying a layer of Blood Angel's red contrast paint to get that nice red glow. Now, here's a cool tip. If your Assault Intercessor Sergeant carries a plasma pistol, you can use the same effect to get a cool blue glow on the coils of the plasma pistol. Just swap out Blood Angel red for Ethematic blue contrast paint, and it'll look really good. There we go, our Volkite pistol is looking extra zappy. Alright, let's move on to the yellow armour on our Lieutenant's tilting plate, and for this we'll start off with a base coat of Avalon Sunset. Then we'll use Iandan yellow contrast paint over the top of it. First of all, that base coat of Avalon Sunset, for this we're using our small layer brush as it's quite a small detail. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot here and onto the palette. Again, we're going to thin it down just a touch with water from our water pot. Like, there we go. Perfect. Then, onto our miniature, we're going to be painting a small line of Avalon Sunset down the centre of our tilting plate like this. Basically, we want the left-hand side to be yellow and the right-hand side to be blue. So it's going to fill in like that on the left-hand side and be as neat as we possibly can. You also might find that painting yellow over blue requires a couple of thin coats to get a nice solid colour, but that's not a problem at all. And over the top of this, we'll add a thin layer of Iandan yellow contrast paint. Just apply quite thinly with a small brush here just to give a slight tint of that orangey shade going around the rivet there. And there we go, that's our lieutenant done. Alright, let's move on to looking at painting power swords next, as there's quite a few of those in the Indomitus box set. For this, we're going to be painting our Primaris Captain. Now, we're going to start off with a base coat on the power sword with Iron Hand Steel. Over the top of that, we're going to use a thin down layer of Basilicanum Grey mixed with Contrast Medium. And then we're going to pick out the power points with Ethematic Blue to give it a weird power glow. First of all, that base coat of Iron Hand Steel. And for this, we're going back to our medium layer brush. So let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and put it onto our palette. Now, Iron Hand Steel is a nice bright steel colour, which is perfect for painting power swords of the Space Marines. Now, a little bit of water here, but not too much. Maybe just a touch. There we go. Perfect. There we go. Right, then onto our Primaris Captain, which we're going to paint it very carefully onto the blade of the power sword, like so. A nice thin coat. You might find, again, you need a couple of thin coats to get a really solid colour here, but not a problem at all. We're looking for a nice smooth coat on this power sword blade. Next up, add a layer of Basilicanum Grey over the top, but make sure we've thinned it down with Contrast Medium. You can see it's going on very thinly here. And also, as we're applying it, we're making sure it's not gathering together in any areas or pooling. See that little pooling area there? Just going to brush that away with our brush just to make sure it's drying nice and even all over the blade. And the last thing on the power sword is just add a touch of Ethematic Blue with a small layer brush just around the power node at the top of the power sword here. And also down around the little nodes going up from the bottom of the hilt there as well. There we go. And there we go, that's the power sword of our Primaris Captain done. There's only one thing left to do on that Primaris Captain, and that's to paint the big white rock he stood on. And for this, we're going to start off with a base coat of Korax White. After that, we'll shade it down with Agrax Earthshade, which we're going to slightly thin down with a touch of water. First of all, that base coat of Korax White. And for this, we're using our small base brush again. Again, a touch of paint from the pot here onto our palette. Maybe a bit more. There we go, perfect. We're going to thin it down just a little bit, but not too much. We want a nice coverage here on this rock. And then onto the rock on the model. Here, we're just going to very carefully apply it onto the rock. Now, don't worry if you hit the base. Obviously, we're going to go over that later on with the basing paints. But do try as hard as you can not to hit any parts of the model you've already painted. Once you've got a solid base coat of Korax White, apply a thin down layer of Agrax Earthshade over the top. We've thinned it down here with just a touch of water, maybe about one part water to one part Agrax Earthshade. I'm just going to fire it over the top of the rock here, making sure it doesn't pull too much in the recessed areas. And there we go, that's the big rock on our Primaris Captain's base done. Alright, so it's time to move on to look at the two black armoured Space Marines in the Indomitus box. This is the Judicia and the Primaris Chaplain. Now, for these two miniatures, we've actually undercoated them here with Chaos Black Spray rather than Macrag Blue, because they're mostly black armoured. The first thing we're going to be doing is a little unusual. We're actually going to be painting over the entire model with a Baden Black paint. Now, you might think this is strange, why am I painting an entire model over with black paint over a black undercoat, but the reason is quite simple. Chaos Black and a Baden Black are slightly different colours, and should you want to go back later on and correct any mistakes, it's important to have a Baden Black over the miniature, so when you go back and correct the mistakes, it'll look the same colour. For this, we're going to be using a large base brush, so let's get straight to it. Here, we're going to be taking quite a bit of a Baden Black out of the pot like so, and onto our palette like this. There we go, we're going to be thinning it down quite a bit, as a Baden Black's quite a thick paint, so quite a bit of water here. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our judicia. We're just going to very carefully paint it all over the entire model, making no exceptions, really. There we go. Nice and easy. Just making sure we're definitely covering all the armoured sections that are going to be black later on. Nice and easy, just like that. Now, once this is done and dry, we're going to go back and paint most of the miniature with methods we've already seen in this video before, such as the gold, the leather, the blue, the metal, that sort of thing. But there will be a few things that are unique to this model, so we'll come back and paint those too. So there we go. I've applied the paints on the Judicia using the techniques seen earlier in this video. But of course, there's a few unique things on this model, so let's get this painted now. We'll start off with that brown robe he's wearing, and for this we'll start with a base coat of Rhinox hide. Over the top of that, we'll apply a layer of non-oil shade to darken it down a bit and give it a bit of extra depth. First of all, that base coat of Rhinox hide. For this, we're using our small base brush. Let's take a bit of paint from the pot here and apply it to our palette like so. Maybe a bit more paint there. There we go. And we're also going to add a little bit of water just to thin it down a touch, but not too much. Excellent. Then, onto our miniature. We're going to very carefully paint it onto the robes here. So this is the brown robes all over our Judicia miniature. Like this, we're being very careful not to hit any of the other parts of the model, but don't worry if you do, as always, you can always go back and correct it later if you need to. Next up, grab your medium shade brush and apply a layer of null oil shade all over the dark brown robe. And once that's done, we're also going to go back and pick out the buttons with Lead Belcher. So there we go, that's the brown robes painted. All right, up next, let's have a look at painting the light bone on the miniature. So that's going to look at his skull mask and also the bones around his chest as well. For this, we'll start off with a base coat of Korax White, and once that's dry, we'll apply a shade of Seraphim Sepia over the top. First of all, that base coat of Korax White, and as these details are quite small in the miniature, we're using our small layer brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and add it onto our palette like so. Again, just a touch of water here, not too much, just to make sure we're thinning the paint down. There we go, that's absolutely perfect. Then, onto our miniature. Here we're going to be applying it very carefully onto the skull mask of the model here, like so, all over the front of the skull. And also, don't forget to paint the exposed ribs here as well on the chest. You can see there's a lot of ribs built into his armor here. We're going to paint those too. And just make sure we're filling in the gap in the middle as well, like so. Once that's dry, apply a layer of Seraphim Sepia over the top using a medium shade brush. Here we've thinned it down quite a bit with water to make sure it's nice and subtle. And once this is dry, we'll pick out the eyes with corn red. And there we go, that's the Judicia painted. Alright, up next let's have a look at painting the bits of the Primaris Chaplain. We're going to be looking at painting the haft of his Crozius Arcanum and also the book he's got on his back as well. First of all, the haft of the Crozius Arcanum, we're going to be painting this red, and we'll start with a base coat of Mephiston Red, and over the top of that we'll apply Blood Angels Red Contrast Paint. First of all, that base coat of Mephiston Red. For this again, we're using our medium layer brush. Again, let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and apply it to our palette like so. Just a bit more. There we go. A little bit more. Perfect. Then a little bit of water from the pot here as well. Just like so. Then onto our chaplain. Here we go. We're very carefully painting the haft of his Crozius Arcanum here. Just making sure it's a nice, even coat all over. You might find this needs a couple of coats to cover over the top of the black. Not a problem at all. Let the first one dry and apply a second thin coat over the top as well. Next up, apply a thin layer of contrast Blood Angels Red over the top here just to really bring out that vibrant red colour on our Crozius Arcanum haft. So there we go, that's the haft on our Crozius Arcanum painted. Alright, last but not least, let's have a look at the book hanging from our chaplain's waist. Perhaps a copy of the Noble Codex Astartes, or maybe a list of transgressors he's after. First of all, we'll start with a base coat of Doomball Brown all over the book. Then we'll pick out the pages with Morghast Bone. We'll pick out the strap with Monfang Brown, and then paint the whole thing with Agrax Earthshade over the top to add some shading in. First of all, it's time for that Doomball Brown base coat, and for this we're using our medium layer brush. So first of all, let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, again, onto our palette like so, and add a little bit of water, just a little bit, not too much. There we go, that's perfect. Then let's flip the model around and look at the book hanging from his waist here. You can just see it here through the purity seals. Here we're going to paint it all over the cover of the book. Don't worry too much if you hit anything else on the book. We're going to be painting over it in a second. Just make sure we're covering the entire cover of this book. Next up, grab yourself a small layer brush and we're picking out the pages of the book in between the cover here with Morghast Bone. Be very careful here. Try as hard as you can not to hit any other areas of the miniature. So take your time and be nice and neat. Next up, we're painting the straps around the book with Mournfang Brown. That's the same way we painted the other straps on the miniature as well. And last but not least, we're applying a wash of Agrax Earthshade over the book. That's the cover, the straps, and the pages. a nice even coat of Agraxer shade over all of it. Now once that's dry, we're going to go back and paint this purity seal on the straps here in the usual way, using techniques we've seen earlier in this video. And there we go, with that our Primaris Chaplain is complete. And that concludes our Space Marine Battle Ready painting video. A few things to remember here. First of all, when applying your base coats, try and be as neat as you possibly can. Don't worry if you make a mistake, you can always go back later on and correct them. Next up, when using contrast paints and shade paints, make sure you don't overload the brush. And also, make sure you go back as the paint is drying to move it around and make sure you avoid any areas of pooling. Last but not least, to complete your model, you'll want to add a cool base to it. So watch out for our Indomitus basing video, also available on YouTube on Warhammer TV. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting!